Hello everyone, my name is Laura López and I'm a bioinformatician at Zeta Genomics, a company founded to commercialize the outputs of the OpenCV project, and I'm happy to be here at BOS to present this poster about OpenCGA, the Genome Optimized Data Store. OpenCGA is an open source software which has the potential to transform the way in which we interact with genomic information. To give a little bit of context, in the past few years, there's been a rise in precision and genomic medicine. For example, the Global Alliance for Genomics and Health is predicting that there will be 100 million whole genome sequenced over the next years. And there's also an increasing number of datasets that are growing into huge sizes, joining the 100,000 genomes program from Genomics England in scale. And looking at this from a genomic warfare perspective, we have the current situation where we write BCF files into generic file storage, and that causes a number of challenges. First of all, BCF files are static text documents which are immutable once they've been written. The second issue is accessibility. You always need a bioinformatician who understands the content of the BCFs, and that bioinformatician also needs local access to the file storage system. Finally, scalability. Any project over a couple of thousand whole genomes needs to be split over a huge number of text files. As a result, the downstream pipelines become very linear, inflexible, and the outputs of the pipelines themselves are yet more static text documents. And we do believe that the generic file storage can be replaced by a genome optimized data store, and that will transform the situation. So in the new workflow, you will stream your genomic data into a data store where it will be normalized and deduplicated at ingestion. Once the data is being loaded, it will be easily accessible over the internet using web tools. And the technologies that underlie this software are inherently ultra-scale, allowing a single repository to be deployed, which is capable of holding pretty much unlimited volumes of genomic information. Looking downstream of the data store, the all clinical pipelines now become real-time queries performed by expert analysts. And this makes the interpretation more iterative, more collaborative, and this finally leads to improved decisions, improved insight, and much greater opportunities for data reuse. And what we present here is our solution, OpenCGA, the leading genome-optimized data store. OpenCGA has been developed over a five-year collaboration between the University of Cambridge and Genomics England. So what is OpenCGA? Well, you can think of it as a platform that provides convenient access to a wide range of users to an integrated dataset which contains genotypic information, sample and clinical metadata, and reference annotations. The next question is, what kind of things could you upload to OpenCGA? The first thing is the genomic data output from your secondary bioinformatics analysis. OpenCGA can be integrated with lab information management system to ingest sample metadata, and also with electronic health record systems to ingest clinical and phenotypic metadata. And all this information can be annotated against the cell-based knowledge base, which is also a product of the OpenCV project. Once everything is loaded within the system, it's then available for expert analysis that can be used to generate research insight. And that research insight then eventually makes its way back into the knowledge base, where it becomes available for further annotation. The other application area is the clinical decision support, using the information for clinical interpretation. Looking into a little bit more detail to the server side of OpenCGA, we have the middleware with the web applications, the query planning, running asynchronous jobs, and the middleware then interacts with the data layer using a web service-oriented architecture. And there's a number of data stores that are used by OpenCGA depending on the nature of the data that's being represented. The genomic variants, the sample genotypes, and the variant annotations are very well represented using a wide column store, whilst the clinical sample metadata are stored in a MongoDB document store. And then the wide column store and the document store are kind of glued together using Solr Search Indexes, which allows query optimization and cross-genotype and phenotype queries. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about the web interface of OpenCGA, the IVA, or Interactive Variant Analysis. By using IVA, you can get a taste of what it feels like to query hundreds of millions of variants in real time. So IVA is very well suited to query data at all scales, from hundreds of thousands of whole genomes down to a single sample from a single clinical interpretation. And IVA offers visualization tools adapted for somatic and germinal data and comes with a great number of user configurable parameters so you can take the most of your data in every possible use case. I'd like to end up by reiterating that OpenCGA is a fantastic software. It's open source, it's freely available on GitHub, and it's been used by several high-profile genomic initiatives. For example, looking at Genomics Finland uses OpenCGA to both the clinical interpretation and also for their trusted research environment. And the OpenCGA community is growing and will be more than happy to more people to join us and really discover what it feels like to do bioinformatics using a big data stack. So please do go to GitHub and check what is this all about. Thank you so much for your time.